Hello, Kumar Sangeet here. Today I have a beautiful story to tell you, which is a touching one too. A group of 15 soldiers, led by a major, were on their way back to the post in Himalayas, where they would be deployed for the next 3 months. The batch who would be relieved, waiting anxiously. It was cold winter, and intermittent snowfall made the treacherous climb more difficult. If someone could offer a cup of tea, the major thought, knowing it was a futile wish. They continued for an hour before they came across a dilapidated structure, which looked like a tea shop but locked. It was late in the night. "No tea, boys. Bad luck," said the major. But he suggested all take some rest there as they have been walking for 3 hours. "Sir, this is a tea shop and we can make some tea." "We'll have to break the lock," suggested one soldier. The officer was in a great dilemma. It was an unethical suggestion, but the thought of a steaming cup of tea for the tired soldiers made him to give the permission. They were in luck. The place had everything they needed to make tea and also packets of biscuits. The soldiers had tea and biscuits and were ready for the remaining journey. The major thought they had broken open the lock and had tea and biscuits without the permission of the owner. But they are not a band of thieves, but disciplined soldiers. He took out a 1,000 rupees note from his wallet, placed it on the counter, pressed under a sugar container so that the owner can see. The officer was now relieved of his guilt. He ordered to put the shutter down and proceed. 3 months passed. They continued to do gallantly in their works and were lucky not to lose anyone from the group in the intense insurgency situation. It was time for another team to replace them. Soon, they were on their way back and stopped at the same tea shop, which was open and owner were present in the shop. The owner, an old man with meager resources, was very happy to greet 15 soldiers. All of them had tea and biscuits. They talked to the old man about his life and experience, especially selling tea at such a remote place. The old man had many stories to tell, replete with his faith in God. "Oh Baba, if God is there, why should he keep you in such poverty?" commented one soldier. "Do not say like that, Sahib. God actually is there," he said. "I got approved 3 months ago. I was going through a very tough times because my only son had been severely beaten by terrorists who wanted some information from him, which he did not have. I had closed my shop to take my son to hospital. Some medicines were to be purchased and I had absolutely no money. No one would give me loan for fear of the terrorist. There was no hope, Sahib. And that day, Sahib, I prayed to God for help. And Sahib, God walked into my shop that day. When I returned to my shop, I found the lock broken. I felt I was finished. I lost whatever little I had. But then I saw that God had left a 1,000 rupees note under the sugar pot. I can't tell you, Sahib, what that money was worth that day. God exists, Sahib. He does." The faith in his eyes were unflinching. 15 pairs of eyes met the eyes of the officer and read the order in his eyes, clear and unambiguous. "Keep quiet." The officer got up and paid the bill. He hugged the old man and said, "Yes, Baba, I know God does exist. And yes, the tea was wonderful." The 15 pairs of eyes did not miss to notice the moisture building up in the eyes of their officer, a rare sight. The truth is, you can be God to anyone. I hope you enjoyed this short story. If you have enjoyed it, why not place your comments in the comment box down below. And again, a reminder, if not subscribed, please consider subscribing and also to share these stories. Thank you. All the best to you. Take care. Stay healthy. Bye.